Fundamentally, employee engagement is not a toolbox of tricks or clever tactics to motivate people. In fact, it's less about technique and more about involving your employees in meaningful ways in the work of your team, department, or organization. I want to share a personal experience that illustrates what I'm talking about, and this was really the moment in my career when I began to understand what employee engagement is all about. A number of years ago, I was hired as HR director of a 2,000-person electronics company and soon found myself leading a staff of 13 HR specialists. The welcome I received was not exactly warm. The staff, in fact, were really upset that their previous boss was gone and that a new young manager from the outside was brought in to replace him, and one who didn't have any HR experience to boot. And how that all came about is another story. But they were right. I had no HR background, and frankly, I didn't want to run the department. But the president of the company, who had brought me in to help make some changes to the culture, was insistent that I take this new role. Well, the start was rocky, with the staff resisting my leadership and everything I wanted to do. And then after a few frustrating and frankly depressing weeks, a light bulb went on. I realized that my staff were far more experienced and capable than me at their jobs. I needed to believe in them and give them support. So I humbly challenged my negative assumptions about their bad attitudes, what I had thought about their bad attitudes and resistance and their lack of motivation. And instead, I started involving them more meaningfully in the work of our department. I started by doing an exercise to define our mission, values, and goals, and the experience turned out to be fun and powerful. We came up with a great mission and mission statement for the department, far better than I could have ever developed on my own, and one in which each member of the staff took ownership and pride. A short time later, it was time to do the annual budget, and I invited them to help make decisions about how to spend our discretionary money. I listened to their input. And the enthusiasm over the next few meetings was palpable as we made decisions together about how to allocate our budget. I got into the habit of going to the staff. Many of my problems or even company problems became our problems, and I learned to listen and let them solve them. I could only do this because I believed in them, and I gradually realized that we'd achieve more by involving them than if I tried to make all these decisions on my own. Well, one poignant example was an upcoming layoff. Three or four members of the staff took ownership of the problem, and they immersed themselves in serious research going back about 5 years regarding the costs of layoffs as well as rehiring when demand picked back up. And the report that they produced was revealing. It showed that the practice was more costly than keeping extra people. So we then developed a 9-step plan for managing reductions in force, which was implemented company-wide and not only saved the company money, but built goodwill with the workforce. That's something that neither I nor upper management would have been able to do if not for the efforts of the members of the HR department. Well, I learned from this experience to trust my staff. I believed in them and listened to them. I saw that they were intelligent and capable people. Not all the intelligence resides at the top. I made the assumption that they wanted to succeed, that they wanted to make a meaningful contribution to the department and the company, and these assumptions made all the difference. I learned that employee engagement starts with a mindset of trust. It has to do with our basic assumptions about people, their intent and capability. In fact, our engagement empowerment initiatives are not going to matter much if we don't make positive assumptions about our people, because that is the essence of engagement. I also learned about the power of involving people in decisions. I not only gained commitment and support, but can tell you that we made better decisions because I let people be involved. Let people that were really on the front lines come up with giving input and participating in those decisions. And that's a core element of employee engagement. You're going to see that in upcoming lectures that employee engagement is not simply about clever motivational tactics. It's about genuine participation and shared responsibility in doing meaningful work. So let's continue. Let's get on with it.